In this section, we'll be dealing with types of groups, creating groups, adding and removing users to groups, manipulating groups, and deleting groups. In this section, we're going to talk about groups within G Suite. Now, you'll notice from the admin console, by default, the groups icon is not shown. This is the default view. Now, you can start to customize your admin console. You do this by dragging and dropping icons from the More Control section. So we click on More Controls, and there's the group icons there. So we'll drag it in. We'll drag in admin roles, domains, app engine apps. Some icons you can't drag in. So you can drag in device management, but you can't drag in billing, for example. So depending on what you want to display, and a lot of admins just leave it all there, but for a more cleaner desktop experience, once everything has been set up, you can then move things down to a section and then hide the section. So we're interested particularly in the groups that we're going to create for C&D Cakes. So let's click on Groups. This displays all the groups that I've currently set up within this enterprise. So we've got Bakery, Finance, Help Desk, IT Department, Staff, the Washing Group. Now, to add a group, couldn't be simpler. Click on the blue button, Create Group. Click. We'll call this group Sales. And we'll give it an email of sales@C&D Cakes. We can give it a description. Group for the Salesforce. Access level. Now, by default, everything is done as public. And public means, as it states, anyone in C&D Cakes can join, post messages, view the member list, and read the archives. Now, sales could be a very delicate area, much like finance or payroll. You can change this by clicking the down arrow and select one of these options. So we've discussed public. The next option is team. Only managers can invite new members, but anyone in C&D Cakes can post messages, view the member list, and read the archives. You can call things an announcement-only group as well, where only managers can post messages and view the member list, but anyone in C&D Cakes can join and read the archives. Very good for company announcements. Or restricted. Only managers can invite new members. Only members can post messages, view the member list, and then read the archives. Messages to the group do not appear in search results. So for something like sales, I would say, yeah, no worries. That's a great thing. We'll have that. For something like, as it says, a team group, the bakery team would be a team group, just to have that little bit more control over things. But as this is sales, we're going to have restricted. Now, we don't want to add all users to the C&D Cakes sales group. We'll do that in a moment. So let's just click on create and create that group. And there it is. The group is created. Now, typically, you've got delete group, add users to group, change group info. Clicking on change group info takes us back to that screen. Well, we don't want to change anything there. Let's cancel that. So you can manage the users in sales by clicking this section or by clicking add users to group. Let's add users to a group. This quick method is quite intuitive. We click on member. We want them to be a member of the group. Enter the names or email address. So let's try. In the sales team, we'll have Dexter Jones. The next, we'll have Nicola Jones. And we'll have Dennis Jones. And then we add. Now those people are then added to that group with members. Now we'll see what I mean about that now. Let's click on Manage Users in Sales. So as we can see, we've got Dennis Jones, Dexter Jones and Nicola Jones, all of which are members of the group. Now this is a restricted group, so we want someone down as the owner. So Nicola is the most senior, so let's select her. Look at the More Actions tab, click the down arrow, set her to owner. The screen then refreshes and you can see Nicola has now been set as the owner of the group with the other two as members. You're also given the option to add more members in this free text field. Let's add Alexander in. Add him as a member. You're also given the option to delete a group. Here. Clicking delete a group. Are you sure you want to delete a group? And it states, members will no longer have access to documents and other objects shared within the group. Deleting the group can't be undone. So we'll cancel that. View groups in service. Groups in service takes you outside of the admin console. Here is the admin console in this tab. And you can see it's opened up a separate tab for the group section of Google Groups. Now, I'm not a member of this group, so I prefer with groups to have admins at least to be a member or an owner. So we'll add me in and have two owners of the group. For all we know, there could be a buyout. Nicola Jones might be bought out as the CEO and owner of C&D Cakes, and then no one will have access to the groups as an owner, and I think it's an awful lot of admin overhead. So by balancing up two owners, or owner and then a deputy in everything, whether that be having two people as a super admin, so if one person is off sick, the entire company does not grind to a halt. Let's add as a member, we'll add as an owner, add. Okay, so I've been added there, see, as an owner. We now have our users within C&D Cakes. We have two owners for redundancy and we have our members. More actions include, if you select the user account, let's take Dennis for example, setting the roles to owner or member. You can remove members, so we can remove Dennis. No worries, there he is, he's removed. Let's add him back in. Right, so groups in service, let's click on that. This takes us out of the admin console group section and into the groups app. Here, you can add a welcome message for everybody who joins the group. Put some nice big letters in it. Spell hello right. Change the colours. All the usual stuff. That way then, when people come in, they see this welcome message. You can also add a new topic. Subject. Methods of selling. You can start a discussion or make an announcement. Display at the top, pin it to the top of an area. Attach files, add people who particularly you want to see. Sell loads of cakes by not eating them. Post. We can also look at discussions that are flagged to us. We can go home where we can view the groups that I'm assigned to and browse all. Look at my groups, where I'm a member of. I guess I'm a member of several groups. You can leave the group out of your own volition. Decide when you want updates to the group. Do you want to be notified of every new message that sends in via email? There's been a new message. Do you just want to send a daily summary? Combine up to 25 messages per email or be notified of every new message. Let's close that down. Here, you can set what level of interaction you want the general populace to have with members of this group. The first section, in access permissions, contact the owners of the group. Who can contact the owners of the group? Currently, everyone. Well, you don't want that. You want members of the group. So let's select those. All members of the group. Who can view the members? By default, managers and members. You can also select all organizational members, but in which case then you would have set this, say, to a public group. View the member email accounts. Select the users of groups. Only the owners should be able to do this. Or you can select the members of the group who can do it as well, but not all organizational members. And who can view topics? All members of the group. Other areas of group administration include the members of this particular group, which you can list here by clicking all members on the left hand side. Invite members. You can send an email in an invitation to members. So, for example, Dexter Jones, I know he's already a member. Please join our group, and you can send invites. You can direct add people to a group. You can look at outstanding invites and look at the join requests. Messages as well. Select pending messages. Any messages that have been sent in to the sales email address, not just individual users, just to the sales email address, which is assigned to this group, you can view here. Email options. You can have footers and display how to post to this group by email and type in some free text. Other options include sales group webpage URLs, display the Google Groups opt-out URL, auto replies. Do you want those auto replies to be shown to non-members outside the organization? Something you have to decide. Setting the default message size. We'll set this at 25 meg. And if you have bounced email notifications, senders will automatically receive a summary of any email delivery problems. Sometimes it's worthwhile to ensure that if an email has been sent to a group and there is a problem, that you get notified. How are people's identity displayed when posting to this group? Either display name or Google profile, the organizational profile only, or display profile name only. Display names and email addresses. Every display name must be unique. Moderation. Who's going to moderate this group? Do you want to moderate all messages, or do you want to leave no posting restrictions for new members? New members' posts are moderated. New members cannot post. Well, this is a sales team, so you want everyone to post within the sales team. And if your posts are rejected, what notification do you want to put in to notify them that their post has been rejected? And spam messages. How should spam messages be handled? Send them to the moderation queue and send a notification to moderators. Tags. So tags are currently disabled, but they can be enabled. Users must enter at least one tag. Well, that could be an overhead for people that you don't want unless you're using Google Plus within your enterprise. Categories. Categories are currently disabled, same as tags. You can categorize posts. So permissions, basic permissions, who can join, select the groups, we've mentioned this, who can post, who can attach files, posting of announcements, all this can be modified, but sometimes tying it down too much can get in the way of collaboration by an administrator and users have been assigned to them. Yes, you can have people invited into those groups and they can request to be in those groups as well, and all this is configurable. There's also another type of group, and this group is called Groups for Business. Now, Groups for Business is a set of groups which are managed by users or department heads or non-admins, and they come in four flavors. You have email groups, you have a web forum, a QA forum, and a collaborative inbox. Now, we'll address Groups for Business in a future topic on a future lesson. Now, as we've mentioned, we can delete groups as well. And by deleting a group, it's permanent. Groups can't be undone. Well, we're going to delete the washing group. Click. And that washing group has been deleted. This has been a quick look at creating, deleting, manipulating groups and some of the permissions and attributes. Not an extensive list by any means, because it is quite complicated and the security model of Google Suite is very complex. Thanks very much for watching. Please take a look out for more videos in this section.